reading that field.
You know, any entity or divine being that we put power into and that is our divine source is always going to have our back. It's always going to be the strongest source of outside reinforcement that you can have. So you're doing exactly the right thing, exactly what I would have suggested to you to do. And the fact that you're seeing improvement definitely backs up the fact that that's just what you need to do.
Now here's somebody then who has basically taken this matter into his own hands and it's working.
He's done a great job. You know, he's really come up with the best thing that he can do for his particular situation.
Lara is in the Mojave area of California. Welcome to the program. Hi, Lara.
Hi.
Go ahead.
Hello. Let me just try and get all this together. I'm out in an area after we lost our house, staying on a friend's property, 8 miles away from everybody from town. And there's a lot of negative aliens and entities and having a lot of problems. And then the phone,
we're losing you on the phone, Lara. Sorry to hear that, but sounds like she's got some issues, though, Katrina.
It does, and she's in a really creepy place. I've worked at Edwards for NASA for a while, and Mojave, Barstow, all of those areas through there are really saturated with negative energies and entities, and so she's going to be in a position where she's going to pick up a lot of stuff. Best thing you can do is have large black rocks in your garden or your yard.
Let's go to Lance in the middle of Nebraska, east of the Rockies. Lance, thank you. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi. My wife and I have been under basically fighting a psychic war with a group of people who are, near as we can tell, a covenant of witches. We only have rumors about them. They started because we took a man into our house and let him stay with us.
Oh.
Violated the rules of the house in some really egregious ways.
Took advantage of you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically. So we kicked him out, and he and this group of people have been literally incessantly attacking.
What's been happening to you two with these attacks?
It's been physical assaults on our bodies. Literally, things where my wife will be sitting there, and all of a sudden a bruise will appear on her.
Oh, jeez.
Mm-hmm.
These people, they're that powerful, these folks, huh?
Yeah, it's a group of about 10 people now, as near as we can tell. And they have done, we think, a human sacrifice against them.
Oh, gosh. Well, collectively, Katrina, are 10 stronger than one?
Absolutely. That's why prayer circles work.
Now, explain what that is.
You know, anytime that, no, it doesn't, again, whether it's for good or for evil, anytime that you harness the energy of multiple people and putting energy toward the same direction, it's going to be more powerful. And that's really just Newtonian law, that when you add to force, the force generated is going to be more intense. And so absolutely this does happen where you stumble upon a situation where a group of people are doing the attacks. What I recommend for you, if you haven't already done it, get yourself cleaned out, get your house cleaned out energetically, and then set up a power grid around your house using railroad spikes and some type of protectant like brick dust, black salt, cascaria, which is ground eggshells, something that's going to create a protection around you.
Let's go back to Lance. Lance, you think you got all that?
Yeah, I did. Thank you very much.
Okay, good luck to you. Hope everything works out. My gosh.
Yeah.
A whole group of 10 people attacking you on a regular basis.
Yeah, unfortunately, that's more common than we'd like for it to be.
And they can bruise, like his wife has been bruised from afar, they can do that?
Certainly. That's probably a poppet or what people would think of as a voodoo doll work, where they're inflicting through a proxy vessel.
Gosh, that's kind of scary, isn't it?
It's actually thought that Elizabeth Woodville did that to Richard III and injured his sword arm.
Let's go to Kathy in Redding, California. Hi, Kath. Welcome to the program.
Hi. Hey, George. Happy belated birthday.
Well, thank you.
Katrina. I think I've been hexed.
Oh, boy. Who do you think hexed you?
My husband's ex-girlfriend.
Oh, all right. And what's been happening to you?
She practices witchcraft and voodoo dolls, and she was very angry because I ended up with her boyfriend.
Oh,
I
see.
It's not like, you know, I stole him away.
How long has this been going on?
Since 2010.
Jeez.
January 31st, 2010.
11 years.
Up until then, I've dealt with things on my own. I've never had medication, nothing, okay? 2010, January 31st, I was going for my morning walk at 6 o'clock in the morning, fell down the stairs of our apartment.
Oh, ouch.
Wow.
You're lucky you're alive, and it broke your neck.
Oh, you know what? That might have been better, George. I mean, I know that's really cynical, but I'm so thankful I have God in my heart.
Well, good for you. We got a minute left, Katrina. This has been going on for 11 years. What can she do?
Unfortunately, that's not uncommon. And one of the most common ways that we see people getting hexed is from ex-partners or from mistresses who want the person to themselves. And the best thing you can do, again, get a good clean out, find a way to get a professional cleaning, or otherwise research how to take a good cleansing bath, cleanse your house really well and set up that protection, because these people don't give up easy.
No, they don't. Katrina, thank you for being on the program. Once again, give out your website, please, and where we get your book.
CrossroadsOccult.com, and you can get the book at Amazon.com. You can get the book at Barnes & Noble, Llewellyn Worldwide. It's pretty much out there everywhere. And George, what a blessing. Thanks so much for having me on the show.
You will probably get a call from our Beyond Belief people and get you into Boulder, Colorado to do a TV show with us.
That sounds fantastic.
Okay, thank you very much, Katrina. Up next, open lines on Coast to Coast. Just about anything goes. Get ready.
Find out more about tonight's guest. Log on to coasttocoastam.com.
Self-evident.
That we humans are capable of doing extraordinary things, impossible things.
Our journey has left footprints on the moon.
And ripples at the bottom of the ocean.
We're at our best when we stand together.
That's when we make the impossible
possible.
That's what Stand Up to Cancer has done.
That's what you've done.
Because you stood up with us.
We cannot rest until we break cancer's brutal grip.
Because of you, there are more cancer survivors every day.
Because of you, survivors are out there enjoying life.
Because of you, we're making the impossible
possible.
And because of you, we'll keep working together to win this battle.
Because of you,
we're committed to making every cancer patient a long-term survivor.
This is the moment to redouble our efforts.
Together, we stand up to cancer.
Join Stand Up to Cancer for one night as we stand together. Because cancer doesn't stop, and neither do we. Tune in Saturday, August 21st at 8, 7 Central on ABC, CBS, Fox, and NBC.
You can listen to KFI everywhere, like you haven't noticed. Here's the rule. Whenever you vote yes on a proposition, it's really no. Whatever the proposition says, it's not the truth. If it is citizens for, it has nothing to do with citizens. It's a special interest group that is saying we are citizens.
Bill Handel.
It's all a crock.
Mornings from 6 to 10 on KFI.
The problem is the expectation I have for my governor is that he worries about simple things. There's a couple of very simple things that you can do to keep California clean. Great.
You have to walk before you run, Gav.
Gary and Shannon, weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
That's the only thing I ever win, is guessing at the spread. If I would have bet it, lost. You know, they say at the racetrack, when Conway has money on a horse, the flag is up, you lose.
The Tim Conway Jr. Show.
Weeknights at 6
on KFI.
So many people are so full of it in these polls that you watch what people do. You don't listen to what they say. Because we're in PC world now where everybody's virtue signaling and saying the thing that's appropriate in public.
John and Ken.
Watch what they do.
Weekdays 2 to 6 on KFI.
KFI
and KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Voter suppression alert. I'm Mark Ronner from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Voting rights activists say the minority vote is being silenced. President of the Los Angeles Urban Policy Roundtable, Earl O'Ferry Hutchinson, says certain measures are suppressing the vote.
Moving the polling places or eliminating polling places, particularly in minority areas. And the other thing is all of these new identification laws.
Hutchinson says eliminating mail-in voting would also hurt voting rights. Friday was the 56th anniversary of the Voting Rights Act, which prohibits states from stopping people from voting based on race or ethnicity. An app you may already have on your phone can help you decide where to dine based on COVID-19 vaccines.
Yelp already shows ratings and reviews from users who have visited restaurants and businesses and also gives you the particulars of the business itself. But now the app will let customers know which places have vaccination requirements for customers and will tell you which restaurants, spas, and bars also have a fully vaccinated staff. Yelp hopes the new feature will help consumers understand how specific businesses are operating as pandemic guidelines continue to evolve. Jennifer Jones Lee, KFI News.
Vanessa Bryant has settled a lawsuit filed against her by her mother. Sophia Lane says she was owed back pay from her daughter. Lane accused Bryant of fraud in the lawsuit, saying she had worked for years without pay as a personal assistant and nanny to her daughter's family. Lane says Lakers legend Kobe Bryant had promised to support her financially before he died. The man in charge of Spirit Airlines has blamed more than 1,700 cancellations over 6 days on bad weather and staffing issues.
When we started canceling, our crews got dislocated through the system. They were in the wrong places at the wrong time. And we needed to start to build that puzzle back together again. And unfortunately, that takes our group a lot of time to do. So we started canceling deeper and deeper into the operation to give them that time.
Spirit CEO Ted Christie told Good Morning America, there will still be cancellations over the next few days, but operations are getting back on track. About 2 million dehumidifiers are being recalled in the U.S. because they can overheat and catch fire. The Consumer Product Safety Commission says the dehumidifiers are made by New Wide Tech. That's New Wide Tech. The company says it knows of more than 100 cases of its products catching fire and causing about $17 million in property damage. SoCal weather from KFI. Patchy fog overnight, low around 62. Clearing up Saturday afternoon with a high around 82. Highs around 70 at the beaches, low 80s in metro LA and OC, mid 80s to mid 90s in the valleys, mid to upper 90s in the Inland Empire. We lead local. From the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Mark Ronner.
All lanes shut down in Costa Mesa, 405 southbound Fairview to the 73 Caltrans work till around 5 a.m. Watch for delays starting at Harbor. All lanes also shut down in Santa Monica, westbound south of the 10, 4th Street to the McClure Tunnel. That's until around 6 o'clock this morning. You can use Ocean Avenue instead. And Studio City on the northbound side of the 101 before Vineland. We have a crash and car fire in the left lanes. It's backing up starting around Universal Studios Boulevard. More road work in Montebello, 60 eastbound Finley to Roseby Boulevard. 3 right lanes coming out till 8. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robert Bucky.
Looking to sell your valuable coins, high-end jewelry, collectibles, or fine art? Dave has a word of caution.
Don't be fooled by the famous TV palm brokers. They don't pay anything.
Why listen to Dave?
I'm a coin dealer in San Diego.
Oh, so where does Dave go?
Tangible Investments. I drive 130-mile round trip to Tangible. I go see Phil. You know, I do it twice a week.
That's a lot of miles, and for good reason.
Coins, jewelry, diamonds, art, watches, anything I've ever sold them, they pay me top dollar. They're super knowledgeable. I've been dealing with Tangible 20 years. Phil is a genius.
There's an easy way to prove Dave right.
Get two or three other bids and then go to Tangible. They definitely pay you the most.
Tangible Investments owner Syl DeGenova has become America's top dealer in coins, precious metals, jewelry, and fine art. And Syl guarantees you'll get more. Take Dave's advice.
If you want to go where the dealers go to Tangible.
Call now for a no-obligation, free professional appraisal. 800-711-2800. 800-711-2800. 800-711-2800.
Find the employees you need to get your business moving. Sign up with iHeartAdBuilder.com and create a custom radio ad to reach job seekers listening to stations just like this one. Get started today at iHeartAdBuilder.com.
We all have wished at one time or another if we could just do two things at the same time. Well, if you're about to refinance or purchase a new home, here are two things you should absolutely do at the same time. Apply with at least two lenders. Mark Tice here from HMS Capital. Having two loans processed at the same time accomplishes a couple of important things. First, it maintains continuing competition for you, the customer, right up to the finish line. This results in a lower interest rate that saves you money. Second, it improves your chances of a successful transaction by eliminating the dependence on a single lender. HMS Capital requires no advance fees to apply, there's no appraisal fee, and no credit fee. With our razor-sharp interest rates, we are completely confident that no matter how many lenders you apply with, we will win your business. So call HMS Capital today and let us show you how doing two things at once really can save you money. Call HMS Capital at 833-255-5698. 833-255-5698. That's 833-255-5698. Or go to HMSCapital.com.
HMS Capital Funding is a DBA of Golden Empire Inc. MNLS ID number 2427. HMS Capital is licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. License number 4130360. Equal housing lender.
833-255-5698.
Tribeca Drive-In returns to the Pasadena Rose Bowl, featuring classic and new films. Enjoy your favorite movies outdoors. Join us now through August 26th for the ultimate drive-in experience. Get your tickets now at TribecaFilm.com.
There are no limits to what we can do together. So let's keep rising, California. Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Your actions save lives. To learn more, visit covid19.ca.gov.
KFI, AM 640. George Norrie, call the wildcard line at 818-501-4109. The first-time caller line is 818-501-4721. To talk toll-free from east of the Rockies, call 800-825-5033. From west of the Rockies toll-free, call 800-618-8255. To reach George via Skype, use Skype name George97313. Send George a text message anytime at 818-298-6521. This is Coast to Coast AM with George Norrie.
Well, those are our friends, ZZ Top. We lost Dusty Hill. The band continues, though. Dusty wanted Billy Gibbons and Frank Beard to carry on, and that's exactly what they're going to do. And we're going to carry on with Open Lines when we come back in a moment. Just about anything goes when we come back. Let's talk for a moment about HelloFresh. Do you like to cook? Well, if you like to cook, here's something very innovative. How would you like to cook when you don't have to go to the store? The recipes are given to you. The food is delivered straight to you. And all you got to do is have fun and cook. And bring the family in on it, too. You can do that with HelloFresh. Try new dishes without all the hassles. Calorie-smart recipes. You don't have to sacrifice flavor or nutrition. No puzzling over complicated directions or hunting down ingredients because, again, they're delivered to you, so you don't have to go to the store. HelloFresh offers 50 menu and market items every week, including dinner recipes, ready-to-eat salads and sandwiches. This summer, they also have everything you need to get your grilling, including grilling bundles, burger packs, surf and turf packs, and so much more, and it's fun. Easy pictures and easy recipes all laid out for you. Go to HelloFresh.com/George14. That's the website. HelloFresh.com/George14. Once you're there, use code George14 And they're going to give you 14 free meals, including free shipping. So that's code GEORGE14 at HelloFresh.com/GEORGE14.
Sometimes the world can seem a cold place, so we gotta bring the warmth to it. Sometimes the world can seem a broken place, so we gotta strive to fix it. At the end of the day, we are empowered to create the world we want to live in. So we prepare for the worst, but we must always, always expect the best. Smith & Wesson, empowering Americans.
We're planning a trip to Spain later this year.
But our Spanish is
pretty bad. So we're using Babbel.
Babbel's conversation-based method teaches you real-life words and phrases. And with Babbel's interactive, bite-sized lessons, you'll remember what you learned.
There's no easier way to learn another language.
Ahora hablamos español.
He just said, now we speak Spanish.
Babbel, language for life. Now try Babbel for free. Just go to Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com.
And welcome back to Open Lines here on Coast to Coast. George Norrie with you. It's our pleasure to be here with you. Let us go straight to the phones. They are lining up Bast in Oceanside, California to get us started west of the Rockies. Hi, Bast.
Hi, George. Thanks for taking my call.
You're welcome. How have you been?
Oh, my goodness. You know, I've been better, but I can't complain.
Yeah, that's a tough time.
Sorry.
It's a tough time for everybody, isn't it?
It is. I do want to say happy birthday to my mother-in-law, Charlotte. It's her birthday.
Oh, happy birthday, Charlotte.
And then I wanted to talk about, because I know you said in about a week you're going to have a guest with, like, Ouija boards.
Next Thursday. This coming Thursday. Next week.
Yeah, I wanted to go ahead and tell a story I have about one while it's on my mind.
Sure.
So, around the time that I found out about the thing in my brain, I started having really bad sleep paralysis. I was like, you know, maybe 16. And I invited some friends over who had a Ouija board, and they set it up. And we were all sitting on the floor in my room. And one of the individuals said, can you give us a sign? Which I know you're not supposed to do, so, you know, I didn't do it, but unfortunately he did. And there was this huge thing in my closet, and everything in my closet fell out.
Oh.
It was terrifying.
Now, did anything happen after that?
Well, I started taking medication for my sleep paralysis, and I continue to have chronic migraines still, and, I still think that I'm either being, like, haunted or, like, I've been, like,
possessed
by aliens or something. It's spooky.
What's a migraine like? I've never had one, thank God.
Oh, my gosh. It's basically, like, it's like what I imagine dying feels like.
Really?
It actually affects, yes.
Does it hurt?
It's, like, so bad. I lose complete use and mobility of the left side of my body, and I lose vision in my left eye.
And does it just come and go whenever?
So I have a migraine with aura, which is a particular type of migraine that not everybody gets, and that's the one that if you take birth control with estrogen, you could, like, stroke out. But aura, for me, is, like, I get these lightning flashes in my vision, and that's when I know it's going to happen.
How long does it last?
Well, lucky for me, I actually have a service dog who's trained to detect my migraines before they happen, so I can take an abortive medication. And they don't last more than maybe a few hours, but they used to last up to 2 weeks.
2 weeks at a time?
Yeah, they're debilitating. They're awful.
Oh, my God. Now, how does the dog understand this?
So right before a migraine, your saliva starts to produce, like, an enzyme. So I trained my dog, along with a trainer, to detect the enzyme in my saliva with scent work.
Wow. And you're taking medication, too?
Yeah, I take a daily preventative, and then I have, like, the abortive medication for when an attack comes on.
All right. Well, you get better. That's fascinating. Yeah, thank God I've never had a migraine, but I do know a lot of people who have had these episodes. Let's go to Mike in Denver, Colorado. Welcome to the program. Hey, Michael.
Hey, George. Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. Hope you are, too. How's your mother? Everybody good?
Yeah, everyone's doing good here. I'm doing okay. It's obviously been kind of a weird week, just seeing the rise in the coronavirus cases.
It's strange.
And, the weirdest thing is, we never expected there to be a resurgence in cases when there's already a vaccine out. That's the craziest thing.
Yeah, the whole thing doesn't make sense, does it?
It really doesn't. But, I'm just praying that we don't have too high of a resurgence. We kind of make it out of this okay. And, George, great week of programming. Thank you for always welcoming, feedback from, younger people and everyone. It means a lot to me. And, I had wanted to ask you a question tonight, George. So, George, there's no doubt that you have changed radio. And, when you first started out, in radio on Coast to Coast, what were some of your goals, long-term goals, what you wanted to see happen with the program?
To survive. When I first came in, I replaced a living legend, of course. Yeah. And Art and I would talk occasionally, and he said, don't copy me, just be yourself. And I said, thank you, no, that's what I expect to do, because I can't copy you anyway. And so I just started doing that. But my goal was to just give people the truth in what we were trying to cover, whether it was a UFO story or a ghost story or some conspiracy or, the COVID situation, to just try to bring people the honest, the goodness, truth, the best way I could. And I hope I've been able to do that, Mike.
Yeah. Absolutely. Oh, you definitely have, George. You've done, you've gone above and beyond in bringing people the truth and, covering stories that the mainstream media doesn't want to cover, chooses not to cover. And I think it's, extremely commendable. And you've done an amazing job. I mean, you're right up with there, like with Rush Limbaugh and people like that that I, looked up to growing up listening to on the radio. And, it means a lot. And, real quick, George, I have to ask you about this because it's kind of interesting.
Sure.
Zachariah Sitchin, we hear so many people talk about him. Obviously, he had so many innovative ideas on, how we could be in contact with extra ETs and things like that. What was it like actually getting to interview him?
Well, we've interviewed him before he's passed on.
Right.
The fun thing for me, Michael, was, and I don't know if you ever heard this story, I had the pleasure of giving him a Lifetime Achievement Award at the Conscious Life Expo years ago.
Oh.
And we brought him up on stage, and he had just turned 90 years old. And we brought him up on stage, and he was functioning. He was doing great. And in front of the crowd, I said, Mr. Sitchin, how old are you, actually? And he grabbed the microphone and he goes, that's very rude. But he was, it was fun interviewing him. His theories are fantastic about the Anunnaki coming to this planet, genetically altering whatever was here that turned out to be us. And it makes a lot of sense. But he was a great historian and a great researcher.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, thank you so much.
All right, Michael, enjoy your weekend. Hope everything works out. Carl in Boston, welcome to the show. Hello, Carl.
Hi, George. How you doing?
Okay, hope you are too.
Yep, well, thank you. I have four comments, I think, and I'll just get with it. It's about a previous show. Well, two of them are about previous show, but I was listening to earlier, and anyway, I'll just go with it. So on July 2nd, 2019, Elena Freeland talks about geoengineering, chemtrails, particles in the air, metals, toxins, and nanobots, industrial and military produced.
Right.
And then what if the nanobots and the vaccine are meant to counter-react the nanobots and the virus? Because that leads me to my next comment. Now, the rumor is that we have this bioengineered virus that is currently mutating, unless like what Jennifer said the other night, that it would end finally. And my next comment is, Pastor Paul was talking in 2017 about debris from the Jupiter. I think it was in March this year. I don't know if it happened, but my point is, you know, the debris and the radioactive fallout and everything that was in Antarctica, you know, meant to switch the poles.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think the extraterrestrials are going to allow that to happen. I think they want, you know, and I'm not even saying that they're in control, but I think that they're monitoring this planet, and I don't know, I just take my answers off there. Thank you.
Okay, Carl. Well, there is that feeling that extraterrestrials cannot get involved in our activities, that they can view things, they can witness things, but they can't actually get involved. I don't think that's the case, because we've had reports that they have flown over nuke silos and have shut them down. Now, that's involvement in a big way. And maybe you're right, Carl. Maybe that if something happens here on the planet, they will step in and save us. Maybe if an asteroid's coming this way, they will nudge it out of the way so it misses the planet. Who knows? Maybe